Welcome to the channel. My name is Mike, and today we're just going to have a little hodgepodge of things. Probably since Wednesday night, I have not felt good. Just exhausted, and I couldn't get over it. My knees hurt, everything hurt. I think a lot of it had to do with digging these ditches. It was hard on me, I gotta tell you. A few other things, probably the flood, just weeks of things that were hard. So I'm feeling better today. There's things I have to get done. I've got to get into this screen patio, get all this junk out of there. These dogs are starting to come, these puppies, they're starting to come out of the tent. They're adventuring, they're curious. I got them eating somewhat solid food. They're not on dry food yet. I'm just giving them a little canned food, and we're wetting it up a little bit, making a little mush out of it, and they lapped it up this morning. So I'll be increasing that and eventually get them on some puppy food, some dry food mixed in. Well, I got a few things I need to accomplish today. Tomorrow on my other channel, Dogman Walking, if you're not subscribed, I'll put the link down below in the description. I've been real bad about doing my walking. We're going to start that again tomorrow. We've got to get my blood pressure down. I've got to get all these things taken care of and get this weight off. And I have maintained, I'm at 265 pounds right now. So those of you who have watched that channel knew I started at 296 pounds and I have not gained, but I have not lost either. So today, one of the things I'm going to do is get out here on my trails where I've cut all these limbs and stuff, get that cleared up. I want it to look nice. And we're going to try to do that at least three or four times a week. I'm going to be busy with these puppies, but if I get up early enough, I should be able to do that, weather permitting. I'm not going to be out walking in the rain, things like that. I can't afford to get sick. So good weather days, you know, I still think we can get three or four videos a week. I'm not committing to anything on there, but it's going to keep going. So today, I'll take you over here in a little bit. I'm digging another ditch. I've only been able to come out here and dig like one or two shovelfuls and go in. But I've got about, 8 feet. I've got another 10 feet to go with it. I've got three more sections of this drainage pipe. It is a more direct route to go downhill, and it works really well from what I'm seeing. So I'm going to try to get some of that dug, probably not all of it. You'll get the idea of what I'm doing. So the first thing on the agenda is get the screen patio puppy proofed and get them some room and think like a puppy. What could I get into trouble with? And get rid of those temptations for them. So that's what we're going to do. If I got any time later, I may, I can't start on the garden until I get this all finished in here. I got to bring in a couple loads of gravel to go on top, because this stuff, you know, I've got to use for at least two scoops. It's cheap, 20 bucks a scoop at my local hardware store, so I'll go get that. And I wanted to say I appreciate everything everybody has sent me. T-shirts, you know, a lot of, I don't mention a lot, and that doesn't mean I don't appreciate it. Connie Riffenberg, you sent me some t-shirts the other day. Much needed, because I have not been able to find t-shirts. I got stuff scattered everywhere. They fit. Thank you for that. A lot of other people that I don't remember or that didn't have names on them. I've gotten dog food, you know. You guys have been great. So don't think if I didn't mention it that I didn't get it or I don't appreciate it, because I do. And every little thing helps me out, and it's going to get even more intense with these puppies as they go. And yes, if I don't get them adopted out to people like you that I know that are good, the remainder will go to Minnesota. We'll go through the procedure with that. The only reason I don't want to do it, I didn't really care to do that, is that now I got to have them 3 months. Because you can't spay and neuter a puppy until they're 3 months old. And I don't even believe in that. You know, I would like them to be at least 8-9 months old before they get spayed and neutered. But I'm not just letting these puppies go to anybody. I've got a few bites for some good homes. but I'm going to ask questions. You know, like I've said before, I don't want people that rent. Doesn't mean they're not good people. It's just in a renting situation, I've seen far too many times where they have to move, and the place they're going to, they can't have a dog. And guess what? The dog ends up possibly going somewhere it shouldn't be. So you're going to have to have a stable background and own your own home. That's the only way I'm going to let these dogs go. Or there better be some good circumstances. So, but we'll get to that. They're already almost 4 weeks. It'll be 4 weeks, I think, one day this week. I don't know. But I got to get started, man. Somehow, I lost an hour. Woke up. I'm like, wow, I don't sleep in this late. I lost a whole hour. I can't figure it out. Here we go. Can't talk all day. All right. First order of business. Get a lot of this stuff out of here. I've got boards. I've got this tote. I've got my generator. And there's a big old saw on top of that. That all needs to get out of here. I need to cover this dirt with something. And I don't want them puppies playing in that mud. There's no telling what's in there. So may bring in some rocks. I don't know. No, I'll cover it with something. I also need to figure out a way to keep these guys confined to a certain percentage of it at night. I don't want them going outside at night. I think Mama's in there with them now. We'll get to see these puppies later on in the video. We've got to switch out their blankets and generally get this cleaned up in here. This should not take too long. All this crap needs to come off of here. I realize it's dark in here. We can fix that. Now I'll pull this off later. It's still a bit cool out. It's 49 degrees. I've still got their heater going. But they're doing real well. They're really healthy. So let me get going. It's time to work. Got a pot roast in the crock pot, and that won't be done till later, but dinner is cooking. All right, I went to start into the screen patio, but I need a place to bring some things. As you can see, I got to get this straw out of here. Some things organized in here, so I got some room. As you guys know, I have been lacking a lot of storage that houses things like this. Not so much in the house. You know, I'm good there. But I need storage for outdoor stuff. Now, I've got my patio furniture out here for now. I've got the tool, the saw stand, chairs, tools. Everything's out here. And what happens is when I need something, I can't find it. Well, go figure. So, I just need to make a little room. I know that I may need my air compressor, so I don't want to bury things that I'm going to need. I probably won't need that saw. There's like a shop vac. I may need that. All kinds of stuff. I know I'll need my weed eater. That's going to be needed today. But I've got to get some things organized. And, you know, this place has a loft up here. But the rats get in there so bad, there's no point in even having it. I can't use it. So, first thing I guess I need to do is just kind of work some things over to one side. I'm probably not going to put a lot of this on time lapse, so I'll just come back. And the new video coming up soon, man. Another shed clean out, because it has to happen. Has to happen. I got to think of somehow to get it. I got to get that air conditioner out of here real soon. All right, let me get started, get some room. Maybe I'll just get the generator and saw. I'll get a corner cleared right here. I think that would be good. That way the generator's accessible really easy, and then the saw, I can just grab it. So I don't need packs. I don't need that cooler or those cords right now, so I can probably put those back here somewhere. this heavy duty.
One thing's gonna kick my butt. All you can do it.
Libby, get out of the shed. You don't need to be in the shed. There's nothing for a dog in there. Nothing. Why didn't I get one with wheels? Why?
I don't need you goofing with me. This hurts.
If there's any air in the air compressor, we'll blow it off. You're a worrywart. Let's see if I got my air knob. Woo!
And as usual, I can't find what I'm looking for.
Just can't find what I'm looking for. You too. That's a joke. That's funny. Almost there. I'm almost there. I don't know if that's a song, but it is now. Waka! Ha! Ha! Alright, generator. I'm gonna come out and I'm gonna get you. I just hopped that generator, and that's all was in the shed. All right, get that stuff in here. It's even more cluttered. Yay. Flooring that was left over, it's all wet, but it's vinyl. It'll be fine. Oh, excuse me. Ooh, excuse me. I'm not going to edit that out either. All right, let's go see what I got going in here. I'll tell you what, guys, you know, I may preach about spaying and neutering, and these two were not. They came to me. I did not ask for these dogs, but they needed care. They were hungry, abused, and I'll tell you, the people that had done that, they're sitting in that building over there right there trying to get to heaven. Well, if they go, I don't want to be in that same neighborhood. Okay, send me the one with these dogs. Oops, we don't want to film your poop. I gotta scoop you. That's right. And they may not all be responsible, but they're the ones that teach their children how to just let these dogs. And you know, it's the culture here. So don't put me in that section if I even go. All right, off that subject. That's a bad subject, but I had to say it. All right, where the dirt was, I had a couple pieces of OSB, just cut it, put it there. I may put something on there to deter them, chair or something like that. I don't know. That I'm going to leave there because it's already blocking the dirt. Okay. They're going to be interested. They get to this point to going out, I hope. And they're going to have the nice outside. And they're all sleeping right now in there. But I'm going to sweep it up, make sure there's no nails or anything. That flood pretty much took care of all that. It's clean. And then I mopped it 4 times. All right. And I may pull off. It's going to be have cool nights for the next 4 or 5 days. So I'm not going to pull any of this styrofoam off the windows because I don't want the screens getting messed up. And when I do, it's only going to be these front ones. Because I don't want Millie trying to claw through the screen on these. For those of you who did not see the build I did, I took 1-inch insulated foam board. And behind that is just a screen. There's no window here. And I just took some little blocks of wood and tacked them in there. We've had some really massive winds that has not blew them out. It has kept all the rain off the windowsills. And so it's done well. So I'm going to take them off carefully whenever the pups are gone and store them for next winter because it makes it a useful room in the winter. You can actually heat it. It's not the greatest heated room, but that little heater there keeps it in the 50s and low 60s. So keeps them puppies warm. So we're pretty good. I got a few more days where they're really going crazy. And so now I think I'm going to move on to getting some of my trails cleared up. Everything's cut. I just gotta take my time and drag it out and make sure they look nice. I want my next walking man video to look good. So puppies have been fed already. They woofed it down. They sure like it. I'm just giving them some puppy food that mixed with water and smashing it up so they don't have big pieces to chew, and we'll be good. Alright, let's get to work, man. Do 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 do. Got me a new bike tree. Pull them caps off. Damn dudes in my pocket. Alright, a lot of y'all don't know. There'll be a sticker on here, okay? 11:22. And what that means, it takes you 11 minutes to put this battery in. But it'd be quicker if you had somebody that was 22. That's what that sticker means, but we're going to ignore it. Go ahead and stick it in. Yeah. And then I got another part I need to buy for this. Flip her down. These things ain't cheap anymore. No, sir. Now, I purposely left a wrench in here. Where is it? Okay, there it is. Go ahead and slick on the negativity. Hey, I didn't tell you to touch that yet. Really need another wrench and hold this side. All right. What you got going on over there that you got a bark for? I'll have to get another wrench to tighten this dude up later. Let's see if we got enough juice to kick it over. And let's see, this is the 5th year I've had this mower, so my battery lasted almost 5 years. that should not happen right there. Got the clip over there and it's cutting into it. So we're gonna take it back off. I'm just going to turn the key on so you can get a piece. Even though I don't like some of them people, I still respect their sense. Hoping it dries up enough. It needs cut already, especially in the dog yard. So we'll wait and see. I doubt it. Just what are you doing? Sitting there waiting for brother? Well, there he is. See, look how long their grass is already. I've got to get in there and cut it. Oh, that is one. It looks like the surface of the moon in there. The way all the holes they've dug when the fifth wheel was in there. Can't even tell where the fifth wheel was now. There's Miss Lily. How you doing, baby girl? Well, hi, sweet girl. What you doing? You hanging out with Millie? Yeah, she wants to come out, but she will soon. Oh, there goes somebody shooting. So here's my solution, guys. Instead of having this go, I'll leave that, but instead of having this have to go all the way down there and then go downhill, it's a much shorter distance to go downhill, just past them rocks that head straight down. So I'm going to lay that pipe in here as well, connect it to that, because all that's doing right now is filling up this hole, and it could be backing up in there. We haven't had a monsoon, but this isn't drained. So I need to dig a more slope pitch here and go off that way and then down the hill. And then once it's to there, I don't care what happens to it. So right now, I'm gonna go on these trails. Get you over here. Now I need to go pick up some diesel fuel tomorrow and get some burning done. I think we got a few days of no rain. So it'll be a good time to do that, but all this is cut. All this is cut. So I'm gonna get a rake and gather up as much as I can and get this out of here. So possibly grass can grow. I'm gonna pick up some seed and throw in here. Maybe try to burn it again. But all this is cut. I just gotta pick it up, get it out of here. And I'm not gonna walk across that. This is the trails I use in my other channel to do my walking. I want to keep them maintained so I can walk all summer. I can still probably do it in the morning. And all that's down there's one needs to be cut. I'll have my little electric chainsaw with me. I want to cut some of this back so I'm not getting smacked in the face with it. We'll see where we get. I'm working on it. That's the first time I've seen a pretty big rock in there. You know, the puppies coming and all that just takes away from getting a lot of stuff done. There's nothing I can do about it. A lot of this needs picked up. Still got milk jugs in there from one of the storms. Got these massive piles to burn. I'm gonna get this log out of the way of the trail. Maybe I'll leave it for an obstacle. Who knows? I'll get that cut up. Nice and green. Still got to get that tree down. We're going to get there. And these trails pretty clear here. Well, what happened when them trees fell? I used to have a trail that went behind that shed, and that doesn't exist anymore. So but this was the original. This is the trail. All I got to do to clear it out is pick up a few sticks. If you remember, this was just full, 10 feet high, full of limbs. And this is my cow manure that was dropped last year, but then the tree fell on it, so I couldn't get to it. So it's perfect now. It's not so hot, but got all this cleared out in here. Just got to drag limbs out. If I could get you to help, that would be nice. Yeah, it would. All right, I'm gonna get to work, guys. Stumps and stuff in here. I think the best thing I can do, for some reason raking just kicks my butt, anything to do with shoveling. So I think I'm just gonna, I raked a few piles, let's go get some diesel fuel and burn this all up in here. I'll get rid of these stumps where I have some nice area to lay some seed. I'm tired of mowing this down every couple of years. I like to have it open for my trails. So I'm gonna burn these piles. Hopefully that'll spread. I've lit this whole thing on fire before. It doesn't go outside of the rocks. You just gotta do it on a good day. So that's about all I'm gonna do, man. And I did find out, I did go to the doctor Wednesday morning. My heart and everything sounds good. My blood pressure was high. But then again, you know, it's always going to be high when you just walk in the office. You know, it wasn't too terribly bad. It's something I can work on. But did find out I got a hernia. So I haven't had any issues with that. I haven't had any pain, but I got to keep an eye on it. And it's just, I've got little spots all over back here that I need to finish. Because here in a week or so, it's going to be overtaken if I don't. My weeds are already popping up. So I got to get this stuff done if I want to maintain this trail for the summer. That makes coming in here to weed eat a lot easier. But if I do my walks every day, I don't think it's going to grow because I'm going to be trampling it down. So that's the plan. We're just going to come in here and get some diesel fuel and come in here and do a lot of burning. Burning is the best way, the quickest way to get rid of things. All right. What's your idea, boy?
Ready? If you pick up a bunch of bags of mulch and put it in here, we'll have a nice dry spot to walk on.
Oh, you mean mulch like that?
Yeah, it's very good. And we don't mind walking on it. You just get some mulch.
Okay, boy, I'll do that tomorrow. What are you doing? Eating some clover? The first greens of the year? That can't taste good.
It's very tasty.
Well, he had a good idea. For once. Gonna put some mulch down in here. And gonna get those two dog houses in the middle down. Tear this thing down. Burn it. And they'll just need their shade shelter there. But then we gotta get to work on that too. Get this waterproof. Okay, good idea, boy. And all the babies are sleeping, and Miss Milligan, she's getting her some sunshine, taking a break from the babies. Yeah, you won't have too much longer, girl. You won't have too much longer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got 10 nipples. You could have had 4 more babies, but I'm glad you didn't. And I'm glad you didn't. Let's go see what she's barking at. Kids. All right. I don't know where Miss Tilly's at. Well, there's them two, them three. Miss Tilly's out there laying in the hay. What do you want? Guess what? You guys get to stay up later tonight because the time changed.
Oh, I like when the time changes, Daddy.
Good. Libby will like it. Take naps. I'm going to do the same. All right, guys. That's going to do it for the video. I guess I tuckered out faster than I thought I would, but we got a little bit done. Main thing I want to do is get that room cleared out for those puppies. And I think they're sleeping right now, and I'm not going to bother them. So you're going to see plenty of them. But be sure tomorrow morning... I'm gonna get out early, and it usually ends up that video comes out about 1 or 2 in the afternoon, depending on what I got going on. So I'll get that video done, edited, get it out there, and get back out here for the next 3 or 4 days. I got a lot of projects if I can handle it, and we're gonna see some videos this week. All right, again, I thank all my subscribers for everything you guys do. Happy trails.